I'm going to start this lesson by noting that tessellate is the most misspelled word in computer graphics, so give it a good look and think of doubling every letter that you can when you spell it. Yes, two L's looks weird to me too, but that's how it works, and I forced myself to spell it correctly. The word tessellate is from the Greek word tessella, which means a small stone in a mosaic. In English, breaking an object into polygons of any sort is called tessellation. In computer graphics, a curved surface is often represented by triangles by placing points on the surface and connecting these together. For example, a geodesic dome is one tessellation of a sphere, such as the biosphere in Montreal. When it comes to making surfaces, the GPU understands only triangles. To draw any polygon, we break that polygon into a set of triangles. This process is naturally called triangulation. Usually, we use the existing vertices of the polygon when performing triangulation. The major rule is that when we add an edge, it has to be entirely inside the polygon. Triangulation is a particular form of tessellation. Here's the same pentagon, tessellated in a fairly arbitrary way, with new vertices added inside the pentagon and connected together. Once upon a time, some older graphics hardware from the 1980s supported objects such as polygons or even more complex objects. For example, NVIDIA's first chip, the NV1, supported ellipsoids as a basic primitive. Graphics hardware manufacturers quickly came to realize that the triangle is a fine building block for almost everything we want to draw. For example, one problem with a quadrilateral is that the surface is poorly defined if all four points are not in the same plane. A triangle's three points are, by definition, always in the same plane, and so have no such problems. By the way, the graphics coprocessor I used to develop on in the late 1980s cost about $35,000 at the time. It was perhaps at best one millionth as fast as the fastest GPUs are nowadays, at only the price of a BMW.